5, 4, 3, 2.
What is up, LTV? I'm Anakin Navarro.
And I'm Frankie Caparan.
Yeah. And we are back with another episode. It's been a while, so let's catch you up on what you missed.
Welcome back to LTV. I'm Brandon.
And I'm Alex.
And today we're gonna ask some Valentine themed questions.
We might get some juicy stuff, we might not.
All right, let's get to it.
Hello, I'm here with William.
And Kimberly.
Allie.
Marilyn.
Rich.
Rihanna.
I'm here with
Jalen.
Ari.
Dr. Barber.
David.
And?
Sebastian.
All right, I'm here to ask you guys some questions today. So, do you have a Valentine's?
Yeah.
Nah, I don't got none.
Girl, no, I'm not asking nobody. They better ask me.
I don't have a Valentine's and I don't plan on asking anyone to be my Valentine. I'm my own Valentine.
Who's your Valentine's?
The girl next to me.
Him. I already have a Valentine.
I'm planning to.
Ooh, planning to. Can we get a name drop over here?
Nah, we can't do that.
Do you ask someone to be your Valentine's on the day of or before?
Sure, before.
You asking before?
Yeah, before.
What about you, Dave? What about you do?
On the day, because it would be more romantic.
What's your favorite Valentine's Day movie?
Ooh, that's a good one.
I don't know. Titanic?
Titanic. All right, what about you?
I don't know no Valentine's movie, bro.
That's kind of hard because I love like all types of romantic movies, but I would have to say like The Notebook. Ooh. Or just like, dang, it's a lot. Like, it's really a lot. But I like you know, comedy romance because Ooh. It's like I could laugh and then be like, oh, they're so cute, like that.
What are you doing this year for Valentine's Day?
Yeah, I'm leaving my mom.
I'm probably gonna spend it with Marilyn or.
If I was to get a Valentine gift from somebody who's one of my admirers and that I don't know, make sure I get the Reese cups.
All right, what's your favorite Valentine's Day candy?
Ferrero.
Well, that's gonna be hard because I like, you know, those bracelets, that candy bracelet you get. I like those, or like, you know, the heart shaped Reese's. Those are bomb.
Now, show me your best wrist face.
Sin City was a mafia.
Now, last one. Look at the camera and show us your best Riz face.
The what face?
Your best Riz face. Like when you go up to someone and like you're about to ask them out.
What's up?
Treat me like what is. Don't get me dirty.
Hi everybody, I'm Ms. Thomas, your college and career counselor here at Luzinger.
Hi, my name is Shem Hyla. I'm a senior here at Luzinger and I'm a part of many activities. I'm the president of the chess club, president of AAA, basketball player, cross country runner, and I'm a part of the school site council.
Hello, my name is Diana Mundy and I am the vice president of African Student Union as well as one of the Code Blue head captains.
Hi, my name is Chalri Kamara. Black History Month means a lot to me, and I guess that is why I am president of the Black Student Union. For me, Black History is celebrating not only our culture, but also our history and our uniqueness as a people.
All right, so Black History Month, it's something that I don't like to think of as just a month because I like to celebrate Black History all year. But if I was to think about it as a month, it is a time for me to send myself reminders. One, to be reflective of what the contributions that my ancestors gave, and to remind me to honor that and to respect that.
One of the things I did to celebrate Black History Month this year was constitute African Student Union. There were definitely a lot of pushbacks, but it was really nice to come together with some of my friends and really empower the African community on this campus and bring it to Losinger. So I was really happy to do that.
Black History Month this year, our club, BSU, really tried to make sure our school's community felt welcomed. And so we had a bunch of different events, like our Sip and Paint event. We had our cultural day and had a spirit week where we celebrated each day, you know, honoring different Black influencers or people who have made a historical impact in our country.
Pursuing higher education is a mode for economic mobility, and it's a way to get to the places that I want to go. And it's great to be, I guess, a role model for that.
Pursuing higher education for Black students is super important because in this country, we have been disenfranchised in many ways. And so the way for us to get our agency back is to pursue education, because that is the one sure way that we can have positions of power and to be able to make decisions for ourselves and for our community.
It was definitely something that didn't feel real. I guess the whole, I remember the night before looking at the resumes of other people who had got into these top schools and like talking with my dad and being like, yeah, don't get your hopes up. It's probably not gonna happen. So when I opened the decision and saw that it was Yale, it was just like something that was like something that I would never thought of. I was very excited the whole weekend, and it became something that just swept me off my feet.
Hi, my name is Brianna Rauda, and I am the chief editor of the yearbook this year.
Hi, I'm Michelle Alba. I'm the president for SportsMed.
My name is Fatima. I'm president of Mecha.
Hi, my name is Mia Rodriguez. I'm a part of ASB, and I'm this year's vice president.
Hello, I'm Sophia, president of Loose Cafe and Catering.
Hi, I'm Stacey Omwa, and I am the vice president of BSU.
Yeah, I just feel like people don't take me serious because I am a female, and I feel like I'm never heard because people always prefer what other people say.
I'd like to say I do, because everyone's expectation of a leader is usually a man. So it's different once you see a man not being in that position.
I got involved into Mecha because I've heard of it from my older cousin. She was in it when she was here, and she kind of suggested that I join as well, and that's how I got into it.
Loose Cafe and Catering always drew my attention because I thrive over hospitality. I thrive over serving people, helping people out, teaching people, so anything around that. And I felt like Culinary Careers Academy always had an opportunity to just be all that. So I got into the academy, and from there on just started helping, having more fun, participating in events and everything like that.
I got involved my junior year. I was just an editor, and I was just do ads for Hiller, and Hiller really liked them, and he thought I was really creative. So he just told me like at the end of the semester that I was gonna be next year's yearbook editor.
Speaking up for myself, because I have had so many times where people would talk over me and talk bad about me because of me being in charge when it was like my first time being a leader, which I showed them that I could do it.
As a female leader, it's very hard to be taken seriously, and I've noticed that my decisions are always questioned, and I always have to like over-explain for what I do.
Not being taken seriously, feeling like my opinions and everything that I have to say weren't heard. So I feel like I have to fight just a little bit more to be on the equal, you know, power level as other leaders.
Last year, I was able to be a part of the decision when deciding the new principal. So that was really cool and interesting.
A unique moment. I think when I first started with BSU,
because you always think that it's not going to be a lot, but then you start to feel like overwhelmed because of how much you have to do. But then you eventually you get like used to it, and then you start like getting in the, yeah, just everything just fits together after a while.
I like everything about it. Like, it's stressful at times because you do have to run a bunch of things, but I think it's being active and being within the club. Like, you know you're somebody, you know you're important, you know you run things, you have your own responsibilities. I feel like it's just that title, and you just know you have a place somewhere in the academy. So I think that's my favorite part of everything, and just working with people in general.
My favorite part is working with my friends and being able to work with other people, because I like to work with others.
My favorite part of being a leader is being able to create my class year yearbook for this year.
Whoa, we are too hot in the business. Ooh, about to make a movie independent. Ooh, need new trucks independent. Ooh, I need you to listen to the vision. Ooh, all your verses sound like dirty dishes. Ooh, I'm about to clean them in the kitchen. Ooh, and we making money by the minute. Ooh, I'm about tonight, to go away. Menace. It's wild, you can lie like a professor. I don't got the time to put you on a stretcher. I am here and I still flex. I am just an icon living. Start a record label, Misfits just did it. Whoa, I'm high star, cover 5 minutes. Whoa, we are so hot in the business. Last verse was before the award show. What? Icon tatted on my torso. Me and Moy dipping in the porso. What? I ain't even taking on torso. What? Damn. Last girl signed a divorce, so what? Now I'm focused and we about to all blow up. We just tryna make the whole crowd go nuts. What? Look, we don't know no one like you. Gold grills and you dance like Michael. No eyes, misfits, no typos. Look, wait, we just wanna make you go psycho. Put $100,000 in the Bible. Ooh, I took the game with my eyes closed. Last verse was before
more. Cause I got a really big team and they need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings. Better be coming with no strings. We need some really nice things. We need some really big rings. I got a really big team. I got a really big team. They need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings. Better be coming with no strings. We need some really nice things. We need some really big rings. I got a really big team, man. What a time to be alive. You and yours. Versus me and mine. Are we talking teams? Are we talking teams? Are you switching sides? Wanna come with me? Look at the smile on me. Look at the aisle on me. I do not chase girls, but they run a mile for me. Say she gon' ride for me. I buy the ties for you. This game is different. You only get one shot when go file on you. Man, f*** all. Man, we want it all. Don't get too involved. We gon' knock it off. And to top it off, I'm with all the dogs. It's a new season, and we still breathing. And I got a really big team, and they need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings. Better be coming with no strings. We need some really nice things. We need some really big rings. I got a really big...
Mama call, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. Was never friendly.
yeah. Now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bags, yeah. But they didn't know me last year, yeah. Everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom. Yeah, yeah. If you quit winning, put your lighters to the sky. How could I make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with that booty, I just put it to the side. Bought a sensor, baby, they could see it in my eye. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it up. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
I was patient, yeah. Oh, I was patient. Hey, oh. Now I can scream that we made it. Now everywhere I go, they say graduation. Young graduation, yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Number old Ben Franklin. Cash. Big rings, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Paso big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, caught up, get in the rows. Top flow lifestyle, top, hunch on post. Malone, I got a play on my phone. You know what I'm on. Hunter Houdini is gone.
I've seen the devil down sunset in every place, in every face.
Like she don't want the limelight, but if you knew it, she lives a lie. She calls a paparazzi, then she acts surprised. Oh, oh, I know what she needs. She just got the fame, I know what she thinks. Give it little taste, running back to me. Put it in the face, pray it's all to keep. Ooh, ooh, every night, she prays to the sky. Is all she ever wants to do. Faking on the knees to be popular. That's a dream to be popular. Kill anyone to be popular. Sell a soul to be popular. Popular. Just to be popular. Everybody scream cause she popular. She mainstream cause she popular. Never be free cause she popular.
Money on top of me. Money on top of her.
A recent scary incident that sent two Putnam County students to the hospital is once again placing a spotlight on the dangers of vaping.
The toxic tricks manufacturers use to hook teens on vapes.
There's been a huge surge of high schoolers using e-cigarettes or vaping. E-cigarettes, though, carry a number of health risks.
You know, my biggest issue with the vaping problem on campus is that we've had two incidents on campus where kids have vaped and passed out.
I feel that we do have a problem on campus vaping, but I also feel that there is a problem in society with vaping. I think that vaping is made so cool or made to be so cool with social media that everybody's doing it.
What I've noticed, especially this year, is the frequency at which vaping has like increased on our campus. I've randomly found vape pens on the floor, some filled, some not.
You know, I guess our vaping safe zone, as our students see it, is some of our bathrooms. And it makes students who don't vape uncomfortable walk to a bathroom where other students are vaping. Not only are they uncomfortable just using the bathroom, but just the smell of the vape. Some of those vapes have fumes that could cause other students to be sick, especially students with asthma. They could be sick if they're smelling the scent of vaping. And it makes other students, you know, it just makes the whole environment feel feel unsafe.
Oftentimes other students who are just trying to use the bathroom are kind of feel awkward, or, you know, because they, instead of being able to use the bathroom, they feel like they're stepping into someone's turf, or they're, you know, being bothered, just kind of trying to go to and from.
I think the last statistic I read was like when they tested 7 vape pens, 4 were found with fentanyl, and they were found with like the minimal amounts of fentanyl all the way to the large amounts. So some of those vape pens that you guys are buying, they do contain fentanyl, and the fentanyl is there to get you addicted. It's not there to get you high, it's there to get you addicted. And the more vape pens you smoke, the more addicted you get. And so you're gonna go from smoking 1 vape pen a day, I mean a week maybe, to like 4 or 5 vape pens a week. So we need to educate you on the dangers of those vape pens, what's in the vape pens, and how, and you know, the dangers they can cause to you.
I will say vaping is not as cool as you may think that it is. And vaping, like e-cigarettes or even like smoking cigarettes further down the line, it is going to have some sort of effect on your health. So you can get COPD, you can have lung issues, you can have asthma, you can have bronchitis. You may not be able to breathe on your own, and then you may need to carry around an oxygen tank or something like that. So it's not as cool as you may think that it is.
For you guys using the vape pens, for you students using the vape pens, you really got to be smart about it. You got to be smart and start to think about what actually are you putting in your body. For the parents, let's be smart about it as well. You know, if you suspect your child of vaping, go through their bag, go through their backpack, go through their little social media accounts. If they're vaping on social media, it's a good chance they're vaping in school and they're vaping with their friends. Go through their backpack and see what they're... Before they go to school, and you know, before you drop them off and before they leave the house, go to their backpacks and see what's in there. Because the only thing should be in their backpacks are things they need for school. That's it.
That's it for this episode of LTV. Okay. If you want to catch up on more school news, follow these socials. See you next time, Olympians.